Hello, and welcome to the CAOrcServe D2D How-To Video Series. In this video, we'll show you how to restore a virtual machine. Each time D2D performs a successful backup, a point-in-time snapshot image of the backup is also created. This snapshot image is known as a recovery point and allows you to locate exactly which backup image you want to restore. When these backups are performed on a virtual machine, or VM, the backup images for each VM are stored at a specified destination. You can use D2D to recover the entire VM from a specific recovery point. If you encounter a problem where your data becomes lost or damaged, you can use this collection of saved recovery points to rewind your system back to a point in time prior to the problem and then restore the known good data that was backed up at that time. In a way, D2D uses these recovery points, almost like a time machine, to let you go back in time and fix a problem like it was before it ever happened. In this video, we'll show you how to restore selected source data to a specified destination using a recovery point. Let's get started. From the D2D homepage, click Restore to open the Restore Methods dialog, and then select the Recover VM option. The Recover VM dialog opens. From here, you'll need to specify a backup source location, choose a corresponding virtual machine for the backup source, and then select a date and session, or recovery point, to restore. First, specify or browse to the location where your host-based VM backup images are stored. Click the green arrow button to verify you have a valid connection to the location if needed. You will need to provide username and password credentials to gain access to that location. Next, from the drop-down menu, select the virtual machine to recover. The drop-down menu includes all virtual machines detected at that specified backup location. When you select a source and a virtual machine, the calendar view highlights all dates in green that contain recovery points for the specified backup source and VM. Click on the date for the recovery point you want to restore. D2D then displays all the corresponding recovery points for that date, along with the time of the backup, the type of the backup that was performed, and the name of the backup. If the recovery point has a clock icon with a lock symbol, it indicates that the recovery point contains encrypted information and may require a password for restore. Select a recovery point that you want to restore. The corresponding backup content, including any applications, for that recovery point is displayed for reference purposes only. When restoring a virtual machine, the entire machine is restored. As a result, you can view but not select individual volumes, folders, or files from within the selected virtual machine. When you are finished specifying the virtual machine to be restored, click Next. The Restore Options dialog opens. From here, you need to choose the restore destination. You can restore to the original location from where the backup image was captured or to an alternate location. Depending on which destination option you select, different credentials for accessing the virtual machine may be required. If you choose to restore the VM to the original location, click Next and a configuration dialog opens. With this option selected, the name or IP address for the destination server and the VM or virtual machine name that you are restoring will be pre-populated and cannot be changed. You will need to specify the protocol that you want to use for communication with the destination server, the port that you want to use for data transfer between the source server and the destination, and the username and password that has access privileges to log in to the vCenter or ESX server that contains the VM that you are restoring. Then click OK to return to the Restore Options dialog. If you choose to restore the VM to an alternative location, the Restore Options dialog expands to display additional configuration fields. For this option, you would only need to provide the credentials to log into the vCenter or ESX server. Note that the vCenter ESX server, VM name, protocol, and port number fields have already been populated, but these values can be changed at any time. In addition, when you specify the details for the vCenter server, you can then view and select an ESX server destination from the drop-down menu. Also, select an available resource pool to be used for the VM recovery, and assign the destination VM data store for the virtual machine or each virtual disk within the VM. Next, specify what you want D2D to do to resolve any conflicts that are encountered during the restore process. The only available option for this restore method is whether or not to overwrite the existing virtual machine. If you select this override option, the restore process overwrites or replaces any existing images of this virtual machine that are located at the restore destination. The virtual machine image is restored from the backup files regardless of its current presence on your restore destination. If you do not select this overwrite option, the restore process creates a separate image of this VM and does not overwrite any existing images that are located at the restore destination. By default, this overwrite option is not selected. Finally, you need to specify the post-recovery option. For this, D2D lets you select whether or not power will be applied to the virtual machine at the end of the restore process. By default, this power on option is not selected. When you are finished specifying the restore options, click Next. The restore summary dialog is displayed. Review the displayed information to verify that all restore options and settings are correct. If the information is not correct, click Previous and go back to change the incorrect setting. If the information is correct, click Finish to launch the restore process. D2D confirms the restore job was successfully submitted and displays the progress on the job monitor. That's it. For more detailed information about this procedure, you should always check the official D2D user documentation. Thanks for watching, and be sure to visit our website where you can view other titles in this video series.